Let me start with something on a tangent. You said progressive Muslim mentioned in the middle of what you said. Okay. I do not like labels. Okay. Liberal, conservative. Okay. I'm liberal on things, but conservative on others. No human, decent human being could be conservative all the time or liberal all the time. It doesn't happen. It's not human. Okay. So labels are not for me, myself, personally. The issue when it comes with, when you say progressive Muslim or a hardcore Muslim or whatever, it depends on the interpretation that this person learned and got convinced with. Okay, so let's deal with that first and put it aside. The teachings of Islam. The idea that you brought, that you found in the Quran, a lot of restrictions and limitations, and not so much of freedom and love. Is that putting it in a?
Well, also it's just very, it's punitive.
Punitive.
It's very punitive.
Okay. A lot of Muslims, believe it or not, think that way. Unfortunately, at least in my time, and I'm not that old, most of the teachings came from scholars who were afraid of people going away, losing the connection. So they focused on the forbidden and the allowed in the teachings, and not so much on the spirituality, which is the real connection. Because in Islam, you have a direct connection to God. I mean, no disrespect or anything, but in Islam, there is no need for a priest or an imam or anybody. You pray wherever you are if you're not close to a mosque. Your prayer is between you and God. You do not need to show no one, and you should not show no one. Okay? So there is a lot of spirituality, but it could be a reaction to colonialism of Muslim land and the fear of the danger of getting away and losing the connection with the religion. So the focus was on the forbidden and the allowed. But if you really take a second look and maybe read a different translation, you'll find more meaning of it. And again, there are, I know of 26 different translations, so I should have brought some with me, but next time.
One thing I'd like to address is the, you mentioned in the Quran that there was equality for mankind, whatever. But it seems in the religion, which seems to be a very paternalistic religion, women very much are on a low rung. They're pretty much treated like seconds, you know, like, I don't know, not equal to men. And which I find very difficult to understand, you know. But there's certain laws that things are very well. If a woman got raped, her family could kill her because she dishonored them by getting raped. If a woman wanted, a man wanted to get divorced, you'll have to correct me, I mean, I may be wrong. If a woman, if a man wants to get divorced, he just has to say three times or something and he's divorced. And when my wife was in Bangladesh once, with family who Muslim and educated, architect, so forth. Women never entered the room with men, they stayed outside. And a lot of women in the Arab countries where these burqas, where you can't see them at all, you know, which must be very uncomfortable in a hot climate. Which to me, there's no love there. It seems that there's really a difference between the men and the women. Women don't really treat, the men don't really treat women like real human beings. A sort of lack of love and understanding there. And I can understand you say you don't like labels, yet women are glad you if your wife wears a kerchief. No? But that's a label. That's good, but that's a label, you know, and I think that's I like to address that, but to me that's like, these people, you know, that's, you know, it's like my husband is a great guy, he does everything good, he beats me every once in a while. I'm not saying Muslim, I don't mean Muslim, I mean anybody. He beats me every once in a while, but he has a steady job, he's good to the kids. But hey, he shouldn't really beat me, you know. Not even Muslim, I mean just generally, you know, the same kind of thing. Like, it's one thing that bothers me, you know.
Now that's another question. But I had hoped it come from a lady. But thank you. You raised a very good question and you gave very good examples of true and false ideas. Women and Islam. Number one. Let's deal with the dress code. In Islam, there is a dress code for men and for women. Okay. The men should not at any time, except in privacy, they must cover from the belly button to the knees. So no speedo at the beach. Okay, that's what it is, that's for men. For women, the dress code is the face and the hands could show in when not in privacy. Okay, in front of stranger men and sometimes in front of stranger women in certain conditions. If these stranger women were known to be harming, whatever, so that's an idea, okay. But there is no forcing to wear anything. My wife is not wearing it. I cannot force her to wear it. It is not my duty. I can advise her. If I don't like it, we could agree to leave each other if I don't like it. Okay, but I should have talked about it before I got married. Okay, you know. So, as far as dress code, when you see a woman like this in the street, stop her and ask her. But in the atmosphere that we're in, don't be offended if the reaction is shouting or whatever, because she might think you're coming to harm her. I'm really being very honest. There is in the Muslim community. In the majority of Muslims, there is a fear factor now because of the past 8 years. Okay, but again, I mean, ladies, you're more prone to meet Muslim women than non-Muslim men. So ask them, are you forced to wear this? Why do you wear this? So again, it is part of the teachings of Islam, which is found in the Quran and the Sunnah. But again, there is no forcing, so that's dress code. Oh, in certain countries like Saudi, and I think it's the only country, they have mandated that women who go outside in the street be covered. Okay, that's the dress code for this country, let's say that. No matter how offensive or not it might seem to you, bars have dress codes. You cannot enter a certain bar or a certain restaurant with shorts, for example. I mean, so this is the situation in different places, different cultures, and different things. But again, as far as the teachings, I cannot force. I can teach my child the teachings, but there is no way I could force her, because here's what happens, and it does happen. Some people think that they should force. I've seen it with my own eyes. Driving my cousin to the school once, and I've seen this Muslim girl with the head cover, school, high school. As soon as the parents' car left, she took it off.